The Calgary Flames missed the playoffs last year. I think it was a disappointing year for the Calgary Flames that they did miss the playoffs. They were fifth in the North Division. And look, they haven't won a seven-game series since 2015. Mike Johnson does a lot of work with NHL Network and TSN. He joins us. Johnny, the Calgary Flames, what are they right now? What are they?
It's a great question because they were not last year what I thought they were going to be. Yeah. I thought they were going to be one of the better teams in the North. I thought they'd be challenging with Toronto for the top of the division, and it did not happen. I think they are a team with limited runway left. Like, I think this is the last year that this group of players, which are pretty good on paper, you look at the names, you look how they kind of come together, you think there might be something there, and it hasn't yet translated to great success on the ice. I think this is a team that must realize that they got to get it done this year, or there'll be more significant changes coming to significant players, more than just Marc Giordano, their captain, who's gone to Seattle.
Right. Look, Johnny Gaudreau is either going to be in a playoff race with the Calgary Flames and they're ready to go, or he's going to be playing on a new team come the trade deadline, because he is in the last year of his deal. Matthew Tkachuk is in his last year of his deal. He's only RFA, you know, after this one, but Gaudreau is a UFA after this one. To me, it's Monahan and Gaudreau. That's what we hear about, right? Like, Tkachuk, I believe, is a big part of the future here, but we don't know if Monahan and Gaudreau are the big part of the future. And I go back to something that Chuck Fletcher from the Philadelphia Flyers said when he was making changes this offseason. He goes, we can't just keep bringing back the same players and expect different results. Eventually, you have to make changes. Now, Giordano, like you said, is gone. He went to Seattle. I don't know that they wanted to lose him, but they were willing to by leaving him exposed. Brought in Blake Coleman, two-time Stanley Cup champion. We know the type of game that Blake Coleman plays. He can play on any different type of line. But was Blake Coleman a product of what he was in Tampa? And can he be what he was in Tampa on a lesser team right now, obviously, with the Calgary Flames? I think it's a big question for this team because that was the big guy they brought in. But that big guy they brought in played a role on a team on a perfect line, basically.
Yeah, but you're right. Yes, correct. But I think Blake Coleman's a pretty good player. You look at his underlying numbers, and even in like he has created and produced at a second line plus level for several years, not just his Tampa years, Jersey years as well. Always kind of was pigeonholed down a little bit lower. So he's probably going to get a bit of a bigger role. He got a certainly much bigger check. And I think he's going to play kind of that second line role. And I believe he will be more than just an adequate second line player. It'll be a different kind of year than when he played with Gord and Gaudreau, let's say in Tampa, but I think you'll see more points. I think he'll be good. Another guy to watch in Calgary that I think might take a step and help him this year, Andrew Mangiapane. You remember what he did at the World Championship, where he was the best player when Canada won the gold medal there. You know, a guy who has been taking strides, fits into the new age game. He's going to play in the top six. He's going to get power play time. Watch for him to maybe take a big step forward, because if you know, Backlund and Gaudreau and Tkachuk and Monahan, those are the four guys that've been around. But if you're looking for other guys to help, Mangiapane and Blake Coleman and even Dylan Dubé, those three guys can also pitch in a little bit. Even if some of those older guys take a step back, those guys can take a big step forward.
Who takes that leadership role that Giordano leaves behind? Is it? I mean, like I look at a guy like Tkachuk and say, I want to help build my future around this player. Like that type of grit, that type of motivation, what we see on the ice, you know, the way he plays, the style he plays with, like to me, he's the guy, and I want to get him signed and have that forgotten about, be a non-issue. We'll deal with Gaudreau. We'll deal with Monahan and all that stuff. But to me, it's Tkachuk is the guy. Do you agree, or am I, where are you laying on that?
Yeah. I mean, I think you're right. I mean, I think there's everything to like about Matt and the way he plays and how he approaches the game. Sometimes I almost wonder, though, if he gets so emotionally involved that it's almost bad to be a leader in that way, you know, like where you're so up and down and on the razor's edge all the time, where sometimes, you know, you got to take a step back as a leader and be the voice of reason, not the voice of who's, you know, house on fire. So there's that. I mean, I think Chris Tanev will help out there.
Yeah.
You know, he's a quieter guy, but he's steady Eddie. And I think Markstrom, although he's a goalie and goalies can sometimes do nothing or do a whole bunch of leadership, he is a leader in that room as well, because there's a void there, because Gio had a massive, massive voice in that room, and they'll have to fill it.
And Markstrom can't play every game. That's the problem.
No.
Right?
No,
it's
an issue.
Do they have a backup? Dan Vladar, they got from Boston, but we don't know much about him in terms of his ability to be a 30-game player in the National Hockey League. I know Markstrom. I know he can be a very good goaltender, has been in the past. He is a good goaltender. He's getting paid like one. There's no question about it. You can get consistency out of him and expect that. But there's another roughly 30 games out there that they're going to have to fill. And if they can't fill that with another quality, with more quality goaltending, they're going nowhere near the playoffs.
You're right. And I think we appreciate, no matter how good your starter is, we know the numbers, we know the analytics, we know the trends, we know the health, all of it. It's maybe an Olympic schedule this year if they go, and I hope that they do. You know, compressed, he's probably going to go. I mean, you're not going to be able to play him 65 games. But it's, I also believe there'll be goalies. There are always goalies floating around the waiver wire. So well, maybe Calgary's not quite done, you know, at the end of training camp, or the third goalie doesn't make it, whatever it might be. They might have a chance to upgrade to a more proven commodity. But you're right. I mean, you need a guy who can play 20 to 25 games and be reliable. And they might have that, but you can't be sure.
Yeah. Another interesting thing, and the last thing I'll go through with Calgary, is the Daryl Sutter effect, right? I mean, full training camp with Daryl Sutter, full season, or at least the start of one with Daryl Sutter. And where does that effect that Daryl brings to a team factor in, especially with guys? I have an idea of where it'll be with Tkachuk. I think he'll be fine. Where will it be with John? Where will it be with Monahan? Yeah.
But Matt didn't like light the world on fire under Daryl last year. Like a lot of people thought that,
but
you know,
nobody
here
does.
Comes Daryl.
Nobody does.
He's his guy. It'll be great. You'll see the best of Matthew Tkachuk. And it didn't quite happen that way. And they went out and got Coleman. And they got Zadorov. And they got players that kind of feel like Sutter type players. I mean, what training camp will allow Daryl Sutter to do will be to establish, obviously, system play of how he wants the guys to play, because sometimes, you know, some guys have a trouble absorbing that midseason. But more than that, he'll establish the personality and tone that that team takes. And I think it's going to be really different than what they've been in years past under a variety of coaches for a variety of reasons. Whether this team can match his required personality and style will tell you whether this team's successful. Yeah. If they can't, because it's something like, I might have not been a Daryl Sutter player. Doesn't mean I'm not a can't play in the NHL. Doesn't mean I'm not a good player. I just not my his kind of player. Mm-hmm. And if they don't have enough guys that are his kind of guys that'll be their best under him, then they're not going to be successful. So that is a question mark, and they'll have to figure it out as they go.
It's maybe the biggest question mark that they have. Quickly, playoffs or no for this team? This is a division that's open. So
wide open
or no? Wide open, playoffs or no?
Yeah.
What do you think?
I'm doubling down on last year's miss, letting it ride. I think they're going to make it again. I think they're going to make it. Because the division they're in.
Look, I understand the division that they're in. There is an open, it's wide open probably after Vegas, but I don't see it. I just don't see enough there. And, you know, the goaltending to me is a big question. Markstrom can't play every game. So I'm going to say no. Mike, you say yes. We'll see on the Calgary Flames.